Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. In that, we are studying topic Structure of Roots. We all have uprooted a plant in our life, but do we know that roots have certain names or certain parts from which they function? Today we'll be studying about that. Structure of root. If we see a structure of root, there will be one primary root, the thick root, and then there will be other secondary or tertiary roots. Now on this primary root, there are certain regions which we'll be studying today. The basal region, or the region that is present downwards, is nothing but the root cap region. This root cap region basically ensures that the root is protected because the ending of the root is always thin and it tapers down. So just to ensure that protection, root cap is given to a root. The second part. Above the root cap region, there is a region of cell division. Inside this region, there are meristematic cells. And we all know that meristematic tissues or cells are the first tissues of the plant which differentiate into different types. So inside this region, what happens is your meristematic tissues basically divide and grow in size. So if they grow in size, we all know that if meristematic tissues are dividing, obviously the length of your root will increase. And if the length of your root is increasing, then the next region has to be region of elongation. In this region, increased number of cells are present, which is region of elongation. Upper region of elongation, what we observe is tiny hair-like structures. And this hair-like structures are nothing but root hairs, which absorb water, nutrients from the soil and give to the plant. Just below the region of root hairs, there is a region of absorption. Now, root hairs and your region of absorption basically together absorb minerals, phytonutrients, micronutrients from the soil surface and give it to the plant. The last region, which is just little below the soil, region of maturation. Now inside this region, it is basically divided that which cell will do which function. Basically, the region which decides the function. In this region, all the cells are completely mature and now they know their function. Which cell will become parenchyma, which will become collenchyma, all those. Structure of a root. Now the basic part which a root consists of are your root cap, root hairs, region of cell division, or you can say region of meristematic activity, and region of maturation. Root cap is a region which is present at the basal part, or you can say the downward part of a root. It is the covering of the root apex or the downward part of the root and ensures protection. Basically, it acts as a cap for the root. Next is your region of root hairs or region of absorption. Now they are thin, delicate hair-like structures that absorb water and minerals from the soil. Region of cell division, or you can say meristematic activity. In this region, cells are repeatedly dividing. And lastly, region of maturation. In this region, cells differentiate. Basically, lengthwise increase happens. This is the structure of root. As you can see, the root cap is at the apex part. We all know that in morphology, the part which is towards the bottom side is called as apex, and the part which is on the upper side is called as base. So root cap is at the apex side and it acts as a protection covering. Next is your area of cell division, or you can say meristematic activities, in which cells are continuously dividing, as you can see. And once cells are continuously divided, it causes a lengthwise increase in the cell number, which is your region of elongation. Just above the region of elongation, there are root-like structures, or you can say hairy structures. And these hairy structures are nothing but root hairs which absorb water. And finally, you have the area of differentiation, or you can say the area of maturation, in which cell gets to know its function. Each and every cell in the root knows what they have to do and how they have to function or work. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about the what is root and what are the various parts of roots and how they function. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.